Hello everyone, hope you all are staying healthy and safe. Here we present our work titled as Improved Phishing Detection Algorithms Using Adversarial Autoencoder Synthesized Data. This is a collaborative effort of Department of Computer Science and Department of Electrical and Computer Engineering at Colorado State University. My name is Shashika Muramudalige and I am a PhD candidate of Department of Electrical and Computer Engineering. The lack of data is a critical issue in phishing detection and also many other networking related problems. In our work, we propose an adversarial autoencoder based data generation technique to improve the phishing website detection. We show that the synthesized samples improve the detection accuracy to a significant level. The proposed data generation method further widens opportunities in other research contexts that suffers from the lack of data for training models or any rigorous analysis. This is the brief outline of the presentation. We will first go through the background and the motivation of the problem. Then we'll discuss the approach and the data sets. Finally, the results and conclusion. First, let's go through the background of this problem. Phishing is a type of social engineering attack that steals users' identity and sensitive information. In phishing website attacks, attackers mimic legitimate websites and attract users in revealing their credentials. Federal Bureau of Investigation, FBI, estimates $12.5 billion in financial losses worldwide, over 78,000 reported incidents between year 2013 to 2018 due to these various phishing attacks. Therefore, this is a critical issue around the world that needs to be addressed at the earliest. This is an example phishing website attack that mimics the actual Facebook website. The left image shows the screenshot of the Facebook website with the original URL, and the right image shows the fake website with a different URL, which is a lookalike to the actual Facebook website. The user may not notice the fake URL and will input the credentials. As soon as the attacker gets the credentials, his account will be hacked. In the same way, attacker can steal your sensitive information such as emails, bank and credit card details. Supervised machine learning appears to be promising techniques for phishing detection in recent years. However, this technique requires a significant number of labeled data in the training phase. Now let's move on to the motivation. There are issues in existing phishing datasets over years in terms of availability, diversity, recency, and quality. The collecting phishing data manually and labeling them is hard and labor-intensive task. Researchers are often reluctant to share their datasets, especially related to cybersecurity problems, due to concerns such as privacy and liability. Only 10% of researchers share their datasets publicly for a similar security networking problem. The training models may be imperfect because of the absence of sufficient data. Therefore, in this work, we focus on how to increase the size of the data while preserving the characteristics of the existing data, but without doing the actual data collection. Now let's discuss about our approach. We develop an adversarial autoencoder model to synthesize phishing data that mimic the real phishing samples to enhance our training dataset. The idea is to generate similar samples with the capabilities and characteristics of the actual attackers. We check the similarity between the synthesized and phishing samples in terms of two levels, that is feature level and the instance level. We demonstrate that supplementing such datasets with adversarial synthetic data can significantly enhance the effectiveness and the accuracy of these detection algorithms. Generative adversarial networks are widely used for images, video and audio generation in the last few years. Here are some of the human faces. Do you think these people exist? The answer is no. These are some of the faces that generated through generative adversarial networks, and these people never exist. This example shows the power of these generative adversarial networks. You can also try this via thispersondoesnotexist.com website. In GAN architecture, there are two neural networks that compete each other to optimize their objectives while training. That is generator and the discriminator. Discriminator distinguish the real samples and the generated fake samples. And the generator confuses discriminator as much as possible by convincing that generated samples come from the real distribution. Ultimately, the generator will be capable of generating samples that are very similar to the real samples. The initial GAN architecture only engages well for continuous and incomplete data distributions. However, we deal with sparse and discrete data in phishing detection and also many other networking problems. Therefore, we use generative adversarial network called adversarial autoencoder, which is capable of capturing both continuous and discrete distributions. Here we demonstrate the architecture of adversarial autoencoder for synthesized phishing data generation. The top row represents the ordinary autoencoder that reconstructs the data from the latent code, which is the aggregated posterior distribution. The middle row shows the discriminative network that predicts whether the samples emerge from the hidden code or the samples come from the user-defined prior distribution. After the training process, the decoder defines a deep generative model that maps the prior distribution and generate data samples from the prior and the decoding distribution. Therefore, the adversarial network is capable of generating data similar to the actual phishing data. Bottom row shows the machine learning classifier is used to determine whether the synthesized samples belong to legitimate or phishing sites. Let's discuss about our datasets. In this work, we use four publicly available datasets. The table shows for each dataset the number of available instances, features, and also the percentage of legitimate and phishing samples. All datasets only have a few thousands of data instances, which may not be sufficient to train an efficient machine learning network for phishing detection. Now let's discuss our experiments and results. In this experiment, we only use the actual samples without considering any synthesized samples. The idea of this experiment is to show the impact of the dataset size towards the classification precision and the recall. We use the dataset number 4, and its split is as 90% of training data and the 10% of test data. Then we use different training set sizes as shown in x-axis with respect to the classification precision and the recall. This graph shows when the size of the training set increases, the precision also increasing, while recall has over 85% of the learning score in each case. In fact, this claims the importance of the training dataset size for precise phishing website detection. We need to demonstrate that the generated synthesized samples are similar to real phishing samples. At the feature level, we need to ensure that the values assigned to the features in the synthesized samples are similar to the real samples. We evaluated this through marginal distributions of both real and synthesized samples. These are the plots for dataset number 2 with marginal distribution for both column and row sum. The x-axis represents the feature number of the datasets and the y-axis represents the marginal probability value. The similarity of actual and generated lines claims the similarity between actual and generated phishing samples at the feature level. These are the marginal distribution plots for all four datasets that further ensures the capability of our data generation technique at the feature level. We are almost having the same marginal distributions across all four datasets. Then we evaluate the similarity between actual and synthesized samples at the instance level. For this purpose, we created a clustering model based on real phishing samples and then tested on synthesized ones. We calculate what ratio of samples belong to each cluster. We use k-nearest neighbor for clustering, real phishing samples, and use elbow method to get the optimal number of clusters for each dataset. This plot shows the ratio in clusters in dataset number 2 and verifies the similarity of generated data at the instance level. As we can see, the same ratios for both real and synthesized samples in each cluster. These are the ratios in clusters for all 4 datasets that further claims the effectiveness of our data generation technique at the instance level. There are some exceptions like in dataset number 1, but overall we can see almost similar ratio in each cluster across all the datasets. With this experiment, we claim the importance of synthesized data towards classification accuracy. This figure shows the detection rate in 4 different testing sets when a support vector machine with a linear kernel has been trained as the classifier. In this experiment, we used 2 models, the initial model and the Poisson model. The initial model trained only with actual phishing samples. We tested this model with 2 sets of real and synthesized samples and calculated the detection ratios. The blue bar shows the initial model that tested with real samples and the synthesized samples. We can see DS1 and DS4 are vulnerable against synthesized samples, and there is an improvement for DS2 and the DS3 datasets. The real detection ratio shows the model capability to detect phishing samples and also could be used as a ground truth for comparing. The Poisson model trained with 80% of actual data and the 20% of synthesized data. For all data sets, the detection ratio for Poisson model tested for both real and synthesized samples are better than the initial model. The Poisson model that tested with real and synthesized sample are shown in brown bars, and we can clearly compare it with our initial model. In fact, this experiment claims that injecting synthesized data in the training set improves the phishing data detection. Now let's discuss the conclusion of our work. We demonstrate how adversarial autoencoders can be used for synthesizing samples that mimics the real phishing samples. We compare the similarity of features and instances of the synthesized data to ensure that the synthesized data can be realistically generated by the attacker. Our experiment revealed that the phishing classification works better when they are trained with large volumes of data. We claim that the phishing data detection is improved by injecting synthesized data into the training set. In future work, we will apply the adversarial autoencoder data generation for other network security related applications, and we'll explore other data quality issues that will make the learning algorithm more robust against these kind of attacks. We acknowledge our sponsors who supported this work, especially the National Science Foundation and the US Department of Justice. Here are the references used in this presentation. We are happy to take any questions from the audience. If you have any further questions or any details required, please contact us via email. Thank you very much.